For I have sinned, my ways I could not see. Now I stand before you, my Creator. Please don't turn your servant away.
When you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you know His attributes, when you know who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, the result of this belief is this fear in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a very, very weird mixture, my brothers. It's a mixture of love. We love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A mixture of fear. We fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A mixture of hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Raja wa khawf. This hard balance that the ulama speak about. For the person to have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and at the same time have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, the ulama, the scholars of Islam, say that the Muslim, so long as he is living on this earth, healthy, full of energy, full of power, he should always have his balance tilted more towards the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should have more fear than hope when you are in your strength, when you still have life in front of you, still there is this, you know, energy in you. What should you have in heart? More fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than you have hope. Hope is when, خلاص, like the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, like Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhum, when he was on his deathbed, he said in some of the narrations, Allahumma innaka ta'lam anni kuntu fi dunya akhafuk fa ana al-yawma arju. Ya Allah, you know that throughout my life I had fear of you in my heart. When he had the energy, when he could pray, when he could give zakat, when he could go for fi sabilillah, in the path of Allah, for jihad, he had this fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now khalas, death has came, the person is lying down meeting Allah, then have good hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hope in the mercy of Allah, hope in the rahmah of Allah. Now, the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, unfortunately nowadays, because of our weak iman, we have a problem. There's a problem in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. See all the sin around you that's happening, the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being broken day and night in your life, in your family's life, in your neighbor's life. All these are actually a result of lack of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the person has fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't fall in sin. He hesitates before breaking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's rules. He is eager, rushes to the a'mal because he has this belief. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran ordered us to have fear of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't think, the Shaykh is being, you know, strict, or, you know, this is extremism or something. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَإِيَّايَ فَارْهَبُونَ. Words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِيَّايَ فَارْهَبُونَ. Do not fear anyone but me. Only fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Shakhir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the companion, said, I once came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was praying. Alright? أَتَيْتُ النَّبِيَّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ يُصَلِّي وَلِجَوْفِهِ أَزِيزٌ كَأَزِيزِ الْمِرْجَلِ مِنَ الْبُكَاءِ. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was sobbing so much, he was crying so much صلى الله عليه وسلم. Alright? To the extent that the noise from his chest was like a boiling kettle. Like a boiling kettle, my brothers. The heart of Rasulullah and the chest of Rasulullah is giving a sound like a boiling kettle from the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the enjoyment of the salah, enjoyment of the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tears would come out of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's eyes in salat. The sahaba, all the sahaba, mashallah, they had this quality. And the beauty of this quality, my brothers, of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that it shows on the person's a'mal. I can tell a person who has fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his a'mal. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the Quran? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. Verily, those people who have fear in their hearts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. They have awe because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ. And those who believe in the verses of Allah and the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ لَا يُشْرِكُونَ. And those who don't associate anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. And people who do good deeds, they rush and hasten to do good deeds, and in their hearts there is fear that they are meeting their Lord. أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ.
One Islam Productions, an Islamic film studio established in Australia, is dedicated to producing films for all Muslims. Just some of the films by One Islam Productions. Children's programs, Islam for Me, We Remember Allah, Storytime and more. Educational films, Pray As You Have Seen Me Pray, Words, Ramadan, Renewal of Faith. Documentaries. We at One Islam Productions believe that Islam is precious and deserves to be presented in only the highest quality. Visit us at www.oneislam.net for more information. One Islam Productions, a film production company run by Muslims for Muslims.